Amendment to Rule 38, Section 10.
Mr. Chairman, by direction of the committee, I move the adoption of the amendment to Rule 38, Section 10, found on page 15 of the committee report. The amendment to Rule 38, Section 10 provides that a delegate to the National Convention is released from their candidate pledge beginning on the second ballot.
There is a white light interrupting action, so the chair will recognize the delegate in microphone 4. Please state your name, senator, and district, the nature of your interrupting action.
Chairman McGinn Russell, Alderson, District 18, and I would like to move to make an amendment to this amendment to change the percentage amount of total vote cast on the preceding ballot to 50% in lieu of 20. So that our delegates can be released to vote their conscience.
Will you help us? Just stay at the microphone a second, and maybe want some clarification on your language and the parliamentarian may have a question. Parliamentarian says that particular amendment would be out of order because it has to be germane just to the nature of the amendment, and it doesn't deal with the Senate rules. So therefore, that you can't amend that amendment to that amendment. All right. There's a motion on rule on microphone 1. Please state your name, senatorial district, and nature of your motion. Delegate 1. Is there a delegate at 1?
I have a point of information. Would this, I'm Jorge Landifar, SD 9, would this apply to this election or just the next?
Not be in effect in this election. And I would just, as a point of information, point of information, we can't change the way that you select delegates for this convention. I know y'all not gonna like it. I don't like it any more than you do. Under the Voting Rights Act, we have to get the Department of Justice pre-clearance. So you can't go to this one. It has to go to next one. That's why it's in that way. Well, I do it too. I got sued, 8 times last year over that district. Not that I want to give the Democrats any more ideas. The microphone on 2 has a white light. We have 9 minutes and 3 seconds, and then by order of rules of this convention, I have to gavel recess. So let's try to finish this one within the next 9 minutes, if we can. The delegate on microphone number 2, please.
Robert Hopper, Senate District 12. Since it's obvious that we're not going to get to the platform this evening or before, that we break at 5 o'clock, and there will be discussion after all the events later, many delegates are probably going to be leaving before that happens, and I'm wondering if there will be a summary, if there could be a summary at the beginning of the session tomorrow that would highlight any decisions that are made about the platform when we meet tomorrow.
I'm sorry, we just don't have the staff. I wish we could. But people can do it on a volunteer basis, use their blogs and tell their neighbors, or go to the caucus in the morning. Maybe somebody at each caucus can give a little report. All right, there's an interrupting action on microphone number 3. Remember, we only have 8 minutes, or we're not even going to get this one done.
Jerry Van Horn, senatorial district 6. And I'm asking a point of information because the Rule 39 in the National Rules says that no one is bound even on the first vote. So, does this invalidate that National Rule 39?
No. All right. There's a motion on number one. Please, we only have 7 minutes, so we can't finish this one up.
Daniel Kalmov, SE10, as the RNC delegates. Being an RNC delegate is a position of public trust, therefore I motion to strike section 10 in its entirety as an amendment to this amendment.
Parliamentarian says that's not in order. We will take the delegate light on number two. And please, folks, if you talk cooperate on this, let's try to finish this topic.
Chairman Munisteri, Tom Washington, SD12, speaking in favor of this amendment to the rules. This would give Texas the ability to be one of the largest unbound delegations at the National Convention in the event of a election for president. We want Texas to have a voice in the presidential nomination. It's clear from our primary state we have a voice. So we can get our voice in the national nomination. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Washington, and congratulations on your election to the state Republican executive branch. There is a motion for And please, folks, just know 5 minutes. If we don't finish, we won't even get this one done because I have to blame the recess.
Mr. Chairman, Steve Miller, Senator District 13. Does a certain number of delegates need to return tonight to continue business?
I have to have a quorum, so please, everybody come back. Or this will be a mess. All right. There is a motion. Well, actually, there's a white light with a red light on two. I'll just go to one to see if there's another motion. Only have 5 minutes, folks.
Dan Pickens, SD 16. I call the question on the